That's a problem. I need to go fix that.
Okay, so I'm pretty sure all I need is brake fluid, because I've had this happen before. I've had the light on and this fixed it. So hopefully it's that again. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Trying to preemptively stop my car problems before they happen, because in the past I've like gotten to the gym and then gotten my car to leave and I've had no brakes, and the only problem was the brake fluid. I just had to bleed the brakes, fill it up, I don't know, car shit. See, one of the pros with living in a city that has absolutely no one in it and going to the gym at horrendous hours is when you leave the gym at 3 a.m. and your brakes go out, you can just drive home at like 4 miles per hour because there's no one on the road. I've had that happen twice, and definitely the most horrendous moments ever. Like, I know driving without brakes sucks, but I don't like to call people and be like, hey, come help me. I like to get home and then deal with my problem. But yeah, I'm gonna head home. I'm gonna put that in my car, and then I'm gonna probably nap, eat my meal, and we're gonna head to the gym. I'm about to go make my pre-workout meal, but I want to show you guys something. So I've got some experimental pre-workout ingredients that I'm not actually going to use. I'm not going to use them today because all I have is a bench session, but in the next video, I'll probably film my deadlift session, and I'm going to use those because they're stronger stimulants for that deadlift session. For those of you guys who eat the same meals every day, how long does it take before you're sick of a meal and have to rotate them? Like for me, it's like 6 months to a year I'll eat the same meal, but I feel like I should rotate them more. It's just I'm not that creative when it comes to coming up with new meals to eat. I don't know, I'm on probably month 4 of chicken and potatoes. I'm not sick of it yet, but it's probably getting close to that. Anyways, I'm gonna just eat this shit, I'm gonna shower, make my pre-workout, maybe eat a Rice Krispies, and then I'll catch you guys at the gym. Yo, so I've just got a push day today. I feel pretty good, but the problem with my bench is it's super inconsistent. Like, one thing that drives me nuts with lifting is you'll come in to do a lift you've done 1,000 times and just completely forget how to do it. Like, your technique is terrible, nothing feels right, even though you did it like 2 days ago and it was amazing.
So this is the fit we have for today. We got the NLA sweater, mortal joggers, and some random Nikes I got. I think I got them at Ross.
Yo, does anyone else still do these even though they're pretty much useless due to like the line of gravity? It's kind of like a habit that's ingrained in my mind from when I first started lifting. No, you can like bend over to make it better, but it's just something I've always done. But yeah, we're gonna get into this bench session. Sorry for all the random talk. Let me know if you guys want more fit checks. But yeah, let's get into it. For the city lights, the 97.5. We're sharing each other, the nearest father, the sound of the lemon drips from your eye.
Okay, so that moved like shit. I'm gonna try that one more time. That's kind of what I was talking about, my bench being inconsistent. But I'm gonna execute it. I'm gonna execute it properly. Okay, so that second time actually moved way better. I wanted to go higher and kind of hit a big bench for the YouTube video, but I don't think it's in the card today. I'm gonna keep it there. I'm gonna stay in the pocket. We're not gonna fuck up our central nervous system just for the YouTube video, and we're gonna drop the weight and do our sets. Can you remember a human life? It was to where we'd energize. Lie in the sand and visualize like it's 75 again. We are the people that rule the world. So one thing that's been helping me a lot with my volume work on bench is holding a deep breath for as many reps as I can before exhaling and like kind of resetting. Like when it comes to bench, when you take a deep breath, you're gonna decompress your sternum. Is that the right word? Decompress? I don't know. You're gonna lose that like higher touching point, like that arch you created, and it's just not gonna be as strong. So the more reps you can hold that deep breath for, the more efficient your technique will be. And I noticed when I keep my deep breath, I can do more reps. It's been helping with my volume. Like those first four reps, I was able to hold my breath for, and they were like breeze. And then the two reps after that, a little bit tougher just because my technique wasn't as efficient. Okay, but that. Okay, so that's all for bench though. It's a decent session. I really want to get 275 for set of eight. When I get something for a set of eight, it's kind of like I've conquered that weight. I feel like I could do it, but it's just I can't stay tight for eight whole reps. Like that's my main problem. Like usually by the fifth or sixth rep, I've taken a couple breaths. My setup isn't as tight, you know, I'm just start getting a little sloppy, but like the first four are beautiful. One thing I always find kind of funny is when people outside the US will see like one person in the US do something kind of strange or out of the ordinary. And this is not everyone outside the US, but it's just like something I see consistently in comment sections. And I had a comment in the last video that was like, what's with Americans always wearing beanies in the gym? Since when has that been a common American thing to do? It's not something I ever see people do in the gym. And he went on to say some shit like, I have been working out for 10 years all across Eastern Europe and I've never seen a single person wear a beanie in the gym. It's kind of like, damn, 10 years of lifting just to lift less than someone who wears a beanie to the gym. And personally, I can get away with it just fine because I just don't sweat. I'm not someone who sweats a ton. Like, even if I go in the sauna, I don't sweat unless there's a lot of moisture and humidity and steam. I just think it's funny how people group Americans like that, like because I wear a beanie, it's just an American thing to do when it's totally not. And he was like, so it's cold enough to wear a beanie but hot enough to wear a stringer? Hey bro, some people actually just wear hats because they like how they look. I don't know, I just thought that was funny. Like that dude was really concerned with some random dude on the internet wearing a beanie. Guys, he's the hat police, the cap captain, the beanie brigader. Is that a thing? I don't know. And he said something like, not hating, honestly just curious. When people lead a sentence with not hating, they're fucking hating. I know this because I did that shit back when I was a hater. I low-key hate trying to line up a bench in the Smith machine. Kind of makes me want to end it all. But I'm gonna get into the hypertrophy side of my workout. I'll probably talk to you guys after the workout. But yeah, I'm gonna toss some music over that. Hope you enjoy it. See you in a little bit. So one thing I always fuck up with my sleep schedule is on my rest day, I'll go to bed at a decent time. Like I get up earlier, that way I can go to sleep earlier, and I usually spend the whole day editing my video. And then the next day I can get to the gym earlier, try to fix my sleep schedule. But then the problem is I'll film a YouTube video. And when I film a YouTube video, I'm usually at the gym for like 6 hours, maybe even a little more. Just because like I'm filming it all myself, so I have to set up every single shot. You know, it's just not the fastest process. You know, I'm thinking of things to talk about, all that shit. The next day, the same thing. I'll come back, shoot some cinematic shots. You know, it just takes a long time. And a normal workout for me is like 3 hours, which is still really long for a workout. Like, you do not need that long of a workout. But I like to spend a lot of time in the gym, take long rest periods. I don't know, it's just what I enjoy. Not like overtraining, I'm just spending a long time in the gym. But the problem is, on the days I film, I just re-fuck my sleep schedule. Back to square one, and I'm getting to the gym later and later. I don't know, I need to like streamline my process more. The issue I run into is sometimes I'll be filming and I run into like the morning people who come in. And the problem with that is this gym has like a really big morning rush, and it's a bunch of like adults and people trying to like go to gym before they go to work. And it's like, I'm not really trying to use my big ass camera around all these people. I know they don't really like that. That didn't happen today, but some days it's just like, gym's absolutely packed when I'm leaving. But yeah, the sleep schedule is forever a work in progress. We're gonna get down one day. Yeah. Overall, not like a great session, but not a bad session today. That second 315 felt pretty decent. It wasn't great, it wasn't bad, it was just decent. We'll take that. But yeah, I'm gonna get in the sauna now, and then I'll probably catch you guys at home.
Very fucking holy, very fucking rare. Marvelous, absolutely motherfucking marvelous, dog. Marvelous.
I don't know why people kind of look at me like I'm some sort of stealing shit from the gym whenever I leave. Like I'm just bringing my stuff home. Come on. I feel like maybe I'm being oppressed some sort of way. I don't know, maybe it's because I bring a camera to the gym. I don't know. You guys tell me.
One thing I kind of want to start doing is having videos.
We're gonna end off the video inside today. One thing I want to start doing is having like a YouTube upload schedule, like every Tuesday and Saturday at a certain time I upload a video. When I say I want to do more videos, people be commenting like, don't try to make more videos, you know, just focus on like the quality of the videos. But it's possible to consistently upload quality videos. Most people like in the fitness space are pretty lazy when it comes to uploading on YouTube, just because it takes like extra work, especially like making like higher quality videos. And it's not like a higher quality video means a better video, but it is possible to consistently upload high quality videos. You know, it just takes a little bit extra work. A lot of people are just lazy. But yeah, I do want to get on a upload schedule. Not just yet, but I think it would be dope if I like consistently, like maybe every Tuesday, Saturday, I had an upload. Somebody, I forgot what they said this. It was either a YouTube comment or it was on like a Q&A on my Instagram story. They commented something like, I thought you were getting strong again. It's like, bro, I had like two bad workouts, man. We're still getting strong. It's not like all uphill all the time, but we're getting there. We're getting there. A couple days ago, I copped some vitamins. I need to get back on my vitamin grind. I've been off of it for a while, but I do notice I feel a lot better when I'm consistently getting in like the right nutrients, the right micro nutrients, you know, vitamins and shit. I do feel like it is worthwhile and does make enough of a difference. My go-tos are like a quality multivitamin, vitamin D3, fish oil,
Also, I'll take CMZ. That's just calcium and magnesium zinc. I'm pretty sure zinc is good for regulating your testosterone. You don't want too much zinc, though. Don't get caught up thinking too much into vitamins, though. I know it's really easy. It's like you see everyone has like this different array of vitamins, and it's so easy to be like, oh, do I need that for my progress? You don't. You don't fucking need any vitamins for your progress. If you guys want to get into vitamins, you know, just get a few basics. That's all you really need. Don't overthink it too much, because that's super easy to do when it comes to stuff like that. And that goes with anything. Like you'll see something on TikTok and they'll be like, oh, you should be doing this through the scapular plane. And if you're not, you've been doing it wrong. You'll think, wow, I've been doing it wrong this whole time. I've wasted all my damn time. But no, you really haven't. You know, it is optimal, but it's not going to make like a crazy difference in your gains. As long as you get down to the basics, you know, you train hard, you get the right food in, get your sleep in, water, you'll make the progress you want. And then you can, you know, dive in a little deeper, make that extra bit of progress. But like 95% of your progress comes down to just the basics. Yeah, if you made it this far, I really appreciate you guys watching all the way through. If you guys haven't, just drop a like, maybe subscribe if you like the content. Drop a comment, maybe just drop a comment for the algo, or tell me what you guys want to see, because I'm open to anything. If you guys ever cop from Rise or Young LA and you guys want to support me directly, you can use code Nick, saves you 15%, all that good shit. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I will catch you next time.